Family, it's your podcast mentor, Jonathan Jones. Make sure that if you're a speaker, coach, or consultant, and you're looking to either start a podcast or you're looking to establish and accelerate your authority, generate leads, and get paid even if you have a small audience, go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com, and up at the top, we have the link to where you can register for the training. Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here, you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. Are you ready? What's going on, family? And welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. I'm your host, Jonathan Jones. And as you all know, this is your number one source for podcast news, podcast how-tos, and also interviews. And today, we have a young rising star out here. got a young Thundercat out here. I'm gonna go ahead and bring her to the show. We're not gonna waste no time. We're gonna go ahead and get into it. But we have Miss Aniyha Jones, who I've just adopted as my cousin, and she's the host of the You're Wrong, Sir podcast. Aniyha, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you? Thank you for having me on.
Yeah. I'm good. I'm well. So if this is the first time, like, people are, you know, coming into getting to know you or seeing your face, yeah, or anything like that, just go ahead, take a moment, introduce yourself to the people.
So hey y'all, Jonathan introduced me. I'm Aniyha Jones, host of the You're Wrong, Sir podcast, but outside of being a podcaster, I'm an undergraduate at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, currently majoring in marketing and then minoring in RST here, in other words, what we call sports management. I got into podcasting a little over a year ago, and it's kind of been something where I've been learning and really just trying to find my way to make an impact within the sports industry.
Yeah, dope. So you just came into podcasting, mm-hmm, but you started studying marketing. Yeah. So how did you go from, you know, because going through marketing and studying all that, and then you're like, I mean, the books is cool, but let me get behind this microphone. Talk about that.
So this was not in my plan. Like, I didn't know. So initially, I did not want to come to U of I. U of I was like my last choice just because of financial decisions. But I wanted to go to Indiana University. And I had fell in love with Indiana because I went there a previous summer for like their business program. I met friends, you know, we built connections. And I really fell in love with the campus. And the thing that I love was that in their business school, they had a sports management major. So I was like, this is the perfect place for me. Got in, got accepted, and money, just enough money did not fall through no matter like how many scholarships I had. And so luckily I applied to U of I and other places, but it ended up being U of I. And I remember coming here and I visited the school for the first time and I was in their business like seminar and they were listing out the majors and it was like finance, entrepreneurship, marketing, accounting, and I'm like, there's no sports management. But I already got accepted into this business school. So I'm like, okay, I want my business degree. I need to figure out, like, what am I going to do? And so the great thing that Geese has is during your freshman year, you kind of have seminars where they introduce you to the different majors. So the lead professors come, they tell you about what you're getting into, what it's about, why it should be good for you. And marketing really struck out to me. A mentor of mine now and a previous professor of mine, Mark Walters, he had his presentation for marketing. And it was like captivating, full of personality, like, this is what you need to do. And I was like, okay, like I had never really thought about marketing before. Everything was just so sports driven for me. But I refused to not get a business degree from one of the top like business schools. So I was like, okay, I gotta figure out what do I wanna do. And then I decided marketing, got my different experiences with different agencies. And the summer of 2020, you know, really me doing marketing kind of had nothing to do with the podcast. Like they weren't like, I wasn't thinking about it. I just started it because I really started getting into podcasts, listening to them. And I just had this day where I was like, I'm going to go start my own and do something different to show my voice. But for me, I was thinking I want to find a way to make my voice within an industry that's very saturated, one that a lot of women aren't in, but it's so many people who want to work in sports. How do I figure out how to differentiate myself from those around me? So that was kind of my thinking when I did it.
Yeah, I love that. Differentiating yourself from everybody else around you. So do you see other, like, because since, you know, just want to make it clear for everybody listening, you're currently a college student.
Yes.
Right? So do you see other college students or many college students like doing what you're doing, just in terms of you putting your voice out through a podcast platform and, you know, you really sharing your message in that way?
So I don't know. I didn't know any personally when I started. I had never known a person who had a podcast. So this was just something new to me. It was something like nobody around me had. I think there's about, from what I know, it's 40,000 students. I don't know everybody. But from what I know, like, there's only about one other person who has a podcast here. So really, I'm kind of like, it was me learning on my own, honestly.
Wow. Man, that's dope. So like just in terms of getting started, were you ever like afraid or fearful? Oh, or are you just like, I'm just going to do this thing. Talk about that. Talk about you being fearful. Talk about that for a second.
Fear is an understatement. So like I was, you know, I'm really a person, like, if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it. So I was like, okay, I'm going to start this podcast. I got everything together, did my research, got my cover art logo. I mean, I'm ready. And I was like, Juneteenth comes, I'm going to drop it on that day. Like, this is what I'm going to do. So I dropped it June 19th, 2020. And I remember I was like, okay, I have my 5 episodes uploaded on Anchor. Like, they're there. Now I have to announce it. I'm going to announce on every single platform. So I was like, Snapchat, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, everywhere. And I always tell people this, as soon as I like uploaded everything, I cut my phone off and I put it on my dresser. And it was like, ding, 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 ding. And people were texting me like, congratulations and this and that. But I was so, so nervous that like I walked away from my phone for about an hour. Nervous because I didn't know how people were going to receive my opinion on topics that a lot of people aren't necessarily willing to talk about. It was something new. Like, a lot of people don't have podcasts around me. So it's like, what is a podcast, you know? And so it was interesting to me. And I was just extremely nervous. But, you know, they say, like, you know, when you're the most fearful, that's when you should hop in and jump in. So I'm glad that I didn't back out because it was the best decision I ever made.
Wow. So now, so to this point now, you say you've been going a year about?
Yeah, a little over a year.
Oh, wow. Okay. So from being fearful in that mm-hmm. moment to now where you are to now, like, what's your thoughts or what's your feelings when you put out an episode versus, you know, when you first got started?
Excited. I was always excited, but I think I was just subconscious about, like, I didn't like it, you know, and me going through it. I think finding more confidence in my voice and in my opinion, the podcast has really allowed me to learn to be okay with what I have to say, whether you agree or not. Because I don't think we as people don't always have to agree. The only thing that I want you to do is get some type of emotion from what I'm saying. And at least if you weren't thinking this way, to be a little open to see where I'm coming from. And so I will say, like, now I drop the episodes without thinking. You know, and I'm always like super excited. I was always excited, but now I'm so excited because I feel like I'm putting out content that I'm extremely proud of. And so really, I think that's all I can ask of myself, and then how people receive it. I hope they receive it well, and we'll see what happens from there.
I'm here for it. I'm here. Your excitement is refreshing. You just like a ball of energy, and I love it. I really love it. And so talk about the name of your podcast, and then break it down for us. Just like, you know, what can we expect to hear on your show and everything like that?
Yeah. So I'm terrible at names, terrible. So I knew what I wanted it to be about and what I wanted to talk about. I was like, okay, I want to do sports. I'm doing it because of this, that. And I text one of my good friends, Jason Mason, and Jason's like a writer, more creative person in a literature, a different way. And I text him and I was like, Jason, I need help with a name. And he was like, okay, like, what do you want the podcast to be about? I'm like, okay, well, like, I'm starting, I want to talk about sports. I want to have controversial conversations. I want to have, you know, conversations about general things with sports. I'm like, I am a woman, I want to host it by myself. A lot of the top sports podcasts I listen to don't have women who are leading it. So that's the gist. He was like, okay, let me think of something. I'm gonna come back to you. I was like, cool. So I was getting other things together, and he had texted me and was like, okay, these are a couple options. He sent me 4 or 5. And the two that stood out to me was Make It Make Sense and You're Wrong, Sir. And I was like, ooh, Make It Make Sense. Like, I like that one. And that was my one. And I was like, wait. And through my research, I had seen, like, you want something that's kind of different than what other people have, especially because I'm starting and this is new. I looked up Make It Make Sense on Apple Podcasts, and everybody had the name. And I was like, okay, so I can't use that because, like, I'm not that well-versed within this, and I need people to automatically have my stuff come up when they look for it. So I was like, okay. And I'm thinking, and I'm like, you're wrong, sir. That's a little aggressive. And I was like, it was the first thing I was saying. I'm like, that's aggressive. And I'm thinking, and I'm like, I asked, like, other people's opinion. Like, what do you think about this? And they were like, I like that. And I'm like, okay. So it started, you know, growing on me. And then at that point, I was like, this aligns perfectly with what I want to talk about and who I wanted to represent. And so for me, you're wrong, sir. It's kind of like a pun. And I think a lot of people always tell me, like, oh, I love your podcast name. And so the first thing that I wanted to do is catch your attention. Like, you may not know who I am, but you may see your wrong, sir, and be like, what is she talking about? You know, and it can make you mad, or it can be like, oh, yeah, like, let me tune in. But you're probably going to look because I made you feel some type of emotion. And so for me, it's kind of defying. There was some advice that I got from somebody named Noah, and she told me a lot of women are going to be like, hey, you know, I'm a woman within sports, and this is so male dominated. And honestly, like, after a while, that gets played out. Okay, so you're a woman. All right, cool. But why should I hire you? Why should I listen to you? How do you stand out within this industry? And that was, like, some of the greatest advice she gave me, because she said that you need to come to people, right, when they underestimate you, and give them and know things that they would not expect you to know. And so I was like, okay, like, this is what I want to talk about. Like, being a little girl, growing up, being a basketball player, you know, as a girl, it's like, oh, you hoop? Yeah, hoop. Play my son. Let me see if you can really hoop. And little things like that. And you always have to get compared to other males and continuously prove yourself. And so for me, it's like, you're wrong. Like, I can do this. I'm knowledgeable. We can dominate this industry also. And it's just really a message too. So yeah.
Oh, man. People used to really do that too. Like, they'll say, you can hoop, play my son.
Yes, like, it, boys, all type of stuff. Yeah, it's like, it's kind of one of those things where it's like, think about loving basketball. Like, literally, those are how my experiences were as a kid. Like, playing basketball, if you tell a boy you can hoop, you're like, you can't hoop. Yes, I can. Show me. And it's like, you're going against each other, but it's always a thing of, like, proving yourself. And so for me, that's kind of, you know, I wanted to relate to the little girl in me, but also the little girls out there who are having that experience that I used to have when I was younger. And so, yeah.
Man, this is so good. Nah, I don't know if you know how good this is, but first I want to just recap some of the stuff that you said thus far. I'm just going to play it back and we're going to pick back up. So first things first, you said before you got started, you said you were fearful. Yes. But then you also came back and you said you did your research. Mm-hmm. Okay, you say you did your research. Then you said after you did your research, you know, you had your episodes uploaded and everything like that. Then you said you published them, right? Okay, you said you had the cover art. Then you said you also had your logo. You said you was ready to go. Okay. Then you said after you put it out there, then you said you walked away from your phone. Mm-hmm. You said, I'm just going to just get away from for a second. I'm just going to let myself breathe. And then you came up with, then you took the time and processed through a name that you knew was going to borderline be controversial. But at the same time, you came up with a name that you knew was going to stand out. Have you ever thought back through all of you've done before? Like, releasing your podcast, have you thought about all the work that you've done and that you've invested into this thing that we call a podcast?
Now I think about it more. I think now I appreciate it more. Cause like, I remember the day that I got the idea that I wanted to start. It was May 18th. I dropped the podcast Juneteenth. That was a month. Like, I was on a straight mission. Like, I was researching at night. I bought the microphone the next day. Like, I was like, I don't know. I had this urge that I needed to do it and I wanted to do it. And I released five episodes when it initially came out. And so I do think back and I appreciate it. At that moment, it was like, this is amazing. But for me, I think sometimes it's even hard to, like, really grasp it. It's like, yeah, I did it, you know, but I know that it's good because I enjoy it. But I do think, like, sometimes it's hard to, I don't really take the moment sometimes to think, like, well, I did that, you know?
Well, I think I mean, I think even now for you, and as you continue to move forward in your podcast and journey, and as you continue to put out episodes and pump out that content, I mean, you're going to get further and further removed from it, just based on the fact of, you know, because now it's normal for you to say, because I saw one of your posts on Instagram, you was like, hey, I can't do this because I got to record content. So now, like, in your mind, you're like, this day or this time is content time. I don't care what y'all got going on. I'm not going to the party. I'm going to record this, do this, and then I might go after. But, you know, so that's more normal for you versus, I don't know if I should put it out. I'm uncertain about it. Because you're past that. Like, you know, it's... Yeah, you're past. Let me ask you this. Because you said you kicked it off with five episodes, and majority of podcasters, you may or may not know this, majority of podcasters stop before 10. They stop probably right around 6 or 7.
I've heard that.
Yeah. So like knowing that and knowing you kicked it off with five, how does that make you feel? Talk about that.
I felt amazing. So I did it because I was doing my research, like on Google, and there was like this article I read, but basically, like, you don't want to just give people a trailer or intro episode. Like, especially when you're premiering it, you want to give people multiple kind of views about what you're into your mind, what you have to say. And so that moving forward, they can start being invested. And so I had seen the article, it was like dropping 3 to 5. And I was like, I'm gonna just go ahead and do 5. And so I was just like, I'm gonna go do it. But for me, it was really great because the reception I got, like, people can listen to different things. So it wasn't just like, hey, Aniyha, I heard your intro. Like, I get a text and be like, hey, I listened to the episode when you talked about so-and-so. And another person would be like, your intro was amazing. Or I listened to this episode, my mom. And it's like, you can see that different conversations were attracting different people. And I kind of gained an audience through different perspectives on different topics. So that, yeah, I didn't even like, yeah, I did it because of research, but that was a great decision too.
Oh my goodness. Aniyha, you make me more proud every time we talk. I promise you. You make me more proud every time I talk. I swear. Okay, so looking back over this journey and even looking to the future. Well, looking over the journey. We'll get to the future in a second. What would you say podcasting has taught you? Like, cuz you're a junior?
Yes, I'm a junior.
Yeah, talk to me. What has podcasting taught you?
It's taught me so much. I would say the first thing it's taught me is to be authentic and, really most importantly, be okay that what you have to say will not make everybody happy. That was a big thing for me. Like, growing up, I had a thing of like wanting to make everybody happy. And so I think that this, me saying like, hey, I'm going to talk about things that are controversial within sports, not stats. But I want to have real conversations. I had to accept that everybody is not going to be happy or agree. And I think it has allowed me to be more confident in my voice. It's also taught me that the people who you think are the most far away are closer than you think. And I mean that by, like, I would make a list of people that I want on my podcast. It'd be like Taylor Rooks, Shaq, Deion Sanders, so many big people, NBA players. And still some people I have not checked off. But as I continue to progress, like, Taylor, off the list. And it's just like, that's a dream for me. Like, when I started it, I was watching her podcast to figure out how do I interview people well. And then I get the chance to interview you. And so a lot of people ask me, like, how did you get so-and-so? How did you get so-and-so? And I always tell people, the worst you can get is a no, but you never know when you will get a yes. Like, a lot of the times when I reach out to people and I send an email or I DM them, and I'm like, I don't know. Like, one time I reached out to Phil Handy. He's a coach for the Lakers. Immediately replied. And I was like, what? Like, I'm hyped because I'm like, Phil replied? Like, I don't know how many people reaching out to this man. But if I would have psyched myself out, like, he too busy. He ain't going to see it. He would have never known who I was. And so those I would say are definitely the biggest things. And three, lastly for me, is you do not have to be a part of a big network to build a platform. And I think I didn't really grasp that until I started watching, like, I Am Athlete, because all the smoke is under Showtime. And a lot of these other platforms are under Blue Wire and things like that, which is amazing to be under a great network. But to see Brandon Marshall build a platform to set up some cameras, invest money, and have your friends, and for it to be something that people are excited to be a part of, it allowed me to see that, like, my vision for how big I want the podcast to be, or without other people, is, you know, tangible, and I can do it. So I would say those are the three biggest lessons I've learned.
Ooh, you over there talking good. You talking good right now. Lord have mercy. Okay, so you talk about what podcasting has done for you. Now I want to just talk about, like, where do you want this podcast to go? Like, where does it need to be for you to be like, I did that, I'm proud of that? What does that look
okay,
like?
So two things. There's this guy heard this, and he asked, like, one of my friends is a barber, and he was like, what makes you want to be a barber? And he was like, well, you know, I like to make people feel good. He's like, we all want to make people feel good, but, like, what are you selling? And he was like, I sell trust. Like, when guys get in my chair, they feel like they can talk to me about anything, whether it's a celebrity or whatever, and they know the information won't leave for me. And so I think somebody who we see that does an amazing job from this is Oprah. Like, people go to Oprah to tell their story, and it's like, I trust that you're going to say the right stuff. I trust you're not going to turn my words. I want the podcast to be a safe place for people, a safe place for athletes, a safe place for people in sports to have real conversations, have challenging conversations, but know that it's all out of love and not out of a malicious place. Honestly, I want mine to be bigger than I Am Athlete. Like, I don't want to be necessarily under a network. I want to build Your Wrong Sir myself. And I want to, you know, have a podcast studio eventually where I have one place where my background is the same. And I want to have a location where people come and it's like, this is Your Wrong Sir. Like, this is set. I'm here, you know? And so I would say those are the biggest things. And also, I want to win an Emmy. I want to win an award for the things that I put out, the conversations, the storytelling, and we're going to get there. I don't know what time and when, but those are my goals.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Man, golly. Oh my goodness. This is you got me just hyped. Because like I told you when we talked before offline, I said it's very difficult. Not very difficult, but I haven't found anybody as passionate about podcasting. Mm. And you're really passionate about podcasting.
I love
and
it.
I'm here for it. Yeah, I'm definitely here for it. So who would you say needs to hear your show most? Like, you know, just with understanding that, you know, everybody can't be our target audience. Who needs to hear Your Wrong Sir
Ooh,
most?
That's good. Whoa, that's a good question. Who needs to hear Your Wrong Sir most? Ooh, that's a good question. I would say the people who need to hear it most are people who don't accept racial issues within sports, who don't believe that they exist. That's a big one for me, who don't believe that there exists. Like, I put a podcast out, you know, in Colin Kaepernick's documentary, recapping it. And in his documentary, he talked about comparing the NFL combine to slavery. And that was the most engagement I have ever gotten under an Instagram post, and all of it was people being upset, and all of the people were white. And for me, I think I was happy they heard it. I was happy they heard it because if you commented under, I made you feel some type of way, but I might make you sit back later that day and think about it, like, is this really, can it really be? So for people who don't agree, who think that, like, women don't belong in sports, or who believe that there aren't any racial issues within sports, I think those people are the people who need it the most, simply because those are the people whose mindsets we have to change. And you have to start being more empathetic with the Black community to understand where we're coming from.
Mm, man, yeah, you're definitely right. Because I posted some stuff on YouTube the other day, just about some stuff that's happening in the podcast world with Spotify. Mm. And boy, if you say anything about Joe Rogan, people go nuts.
They love him.
Like, people love, I didn't know it was that serious until I put up a couple of YouTube shorts, and people are going nuts about Joe Rogan.
Joe.
I didn't know it was that real. I didn't know it was that. They probably love Joe Rogan more than they like Joe Biden. Good.
Oh, yes.
It's wild out here in these podcast streets, man. It's wild. All right. Okay. So Okay, so you gave us the backstory of, you know, where you started. Mm-hmm. You talked a little bit about, you know, what podcasting has taught you. You even talked about some of the people you've had on your show. Who would be the dream guest? So like let's say mm-hmm. let's say you get the opportunity to go out to dinner, right? I'm gonna give you three people. You get to interview these three people. They can do three separate interviews. Don't get too caught up in the details, but you get to interview these three people. Then after that, y'all gonna go to dinner together and y'all gonna kick it. Who are these three people?
Deion Sanders, LeBron, and that's so good. LeBron and I want to talk to Issa Rae. Yeah.
Okay. Now you got to give me. You got to give me the why on each of them. You said Deion. You said Prime. Why we want to talk to Coach Prime?
Yeah. So Prime for me, because I think he has always been a marketing guru from jump, and in terms of a person who knows how to like build a community to follow you and be around you anywhere, I think he's one of the best at that. But I also want to talk about the impact of HBCU sports. Like, why Jackson State for real? Like, you know, what was your thinking with other things and the movement, that ideology? I would love to talk about that and to know his long-term vision for Jackson State. That would be my thing. LeBron, I don't necessarily want to talk about the game. I want to talk about off the court. Like, we know he's great. We know this, we know that. But I want to have like real conversations. Like, you know, if I was to ask him a question, you know, he regrets having Bronny as a junior because of the hype that comes from it and the attention. I want to talk about different things, balancing parenthood. How do you have a group of friends where you have confidence to know that these people are the perfect people to guide your career? And like, y'all don't even really know what y'all doing for real, you know? That would be something. And then Issa's good for me because I know like she isn't like the person in sports, but I would tailor it for podcasters to hear in general, because what she did was have a show on YouTube and produce it herself and film with her friends and roles on YouTube. And now you have a hit show on HBO and different things like that. How do you reach out to companies and start trusting that they won't steal your idea? How do you get in the hands of companies like that? You know, because podcasters want to get outside of just the living room where they're recording on the couch. How do we get there? How do I get a deal with the top network or things of that sort? So for me, I think the conversation will be, how do I go from just a creator, a small creator, to somebody that people respect their creation and they yearn for like your ideas?
Man, that'd be a fire conversation. I mean, all those individually, but then sitting at the table together, that would be, oh my goodness. You have to have the camera set up and everything. It'd have to be like a The Shot.
Yes.
it would have to be. It would only be right. You know, it'd only be right. It'd only be right. Man. Okay. So we're going to wind this thing down. I'm going to get ready to land this plane in just a second. But before we do that, I'd like to have a little bit of fun. So I got a little bit of rapid fire. Okay. And this is a little segment I like to call This or That. Okay. So you're going to pick, you know, one or the other, right? Okay. So are you
ready?
All right. Here we go. Football or basketball?
Basketball.
Okay. Facebook or Instagram? Oh, yeah. You don't remember Facebook. You're right. Martin or Fresh Prince?
Ooh, Martin.
Okay. Deep dish or flat crust?
Flat crust.
Popeyes or Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A.
Do y'all have Chick-fil-A?
Yeah.
Okay. You prefer a small party or a big gathering?
Small party.
Okay. And then cookies or cake?
Cake.
All right. Good deal. And then please let the good people know where they can find you, how they can follow you, connect with you, all that good stuff.
Yeah. So you can type, I'm on LinkedIn, Instagram, all of that. So on Instagram, you can just type in Aniyha Jones, or my username is NIYH and then 3 A's, a period and underscore. So either or works, and you can find the podcast is streaming on all streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Overcast, etc. at Your Own Sir. Yeah, that's where you can find me. And if you guys do end up tuning in, I really, really appreciate you.
Boom. There it is. There it is. And last question. I just wanted to start asking people this because, you know, we're focusing on helping people gain some exposure on the platform. Mm-hmm. But who's one slept on podcaster that I should interview next?
Okay. Can I say two? Or can I say one?
Go ahead. Yeah.
My first one is a good friend of mine, Matt Loopy. He has a podcast called Define Success Podcast. And it's really great because he like interviews different people to see what their definition of success is. And so everybody's is really different. I would say it's extremely motivational. So that would be a person. And also Joshua has a podcast called Agent Talk. And basically Joshua's an NFL agent, but I think it's really good because he shows himself on all facets outside of being an agent. So it's family, the Bible, etc. So you can see him just being more holistic, like being more than an agent.
Boom. There it is. There it is. There it is. Well, Aniyha, I appreciate you coming on. I appreciate you stopping by. I'm going to give you one final chance, though, but I just want to give you a chance just to, you know, leave a final word with the people. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, if you have a final thought you just want to drop on the people out there who might be listening, mm-hmm. who might be tapped in. Talk to the people.
I would say keep going. Me and Joshua are really close, and I had a point where I was like really down, just about like frustration, things not going my way. And he talked about this story where like his marriage counselor had adopted a child who was Black and she was white. And I remember they were in a store and a lady asked the little girl, like, is this your mom or something like that? And the girl was like, why wouldn't she think you're a mom or something like that? And she told her daughter, like, they just can't see. And so I say that to say, like, a lot of people won't be able to see your vision or see how big it'll be or understand where you're coming from. But that's okay. Like, keep going, keep moving, keep being patient. I'm trying to learn to be more patient. But whatever you have in mind, like, I feel like if we have dreams about our visions, God placed that on us. And so it's for a purpose. Like, keep going. It's okay if they can't see because you do.
Good God. Yeah, Aniyha came through here and she just wrecked the podcast. Lord have mercy. Oh my goodness. You came through and wrecked the show, wrecked shop. Good God. Man, we got to get out of here. We got to get out of here. Man, Aniyha, thank you. Thank you so much. So much again for, you know, coming by, blessing the mic, blessing the show. And everybody out there, you know, who tuned in, tapped in, make sure to follow Aniyha, make sure to connect with her. I'm gonna have all her information down in the show notes. But this is the Your Podcast Mentor Show, where we help you, you know, build your platform so that you can profit on purpose from your podcast. Peace. Yeah. God bless.